G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week's tutorial is all about using that character that I created in my last tutorial. I'm calling this Composite Clash of the Forces. So as usual, let's get going. So you can see that I've got all of my assets already named over here on the right-hand side of my Affinity Photo window. The first thing I'm going to do is use this road photo here. That's a picture of a tunnel and a road. I'm going to grab my pen tool. And I only want part of this road. I only want sort of this part of the road here. So I'm going to start off my pen tool right on the edge here and go all the way down right to the end, cross, and again all the way down to this end. And I only want this part of the road that I've highlighted here. Going to come up here to selection and just make a selection of that section that I want. Going to invert the selection up here and then hit delete. Get rid of the marching ants with my command D and you can see that I've got my road image in place. Grab my move tool. I'm going to move the road just down a little bit. The next picture that I'm going to turn on is the city background here. So I'm just going to turn on my city and then back on the road, I'll come over here to my perspective tool here and I'm just going to drag that road up a little bit. Up to about there and hit apply. So I've got my road sort of in place near my city. On my road, I will add a exposure. Clip that to the road and I'm going to darken that road down a little bit. We will put one on the city as well, an exposure on the city. Onto the city, just down a tiny little bit, not too much. So the next picture that I'll add is my sky. So I've got a picture of the sky here. So I'm just going to add that in. Got a picture of my sky here. And I've just manipulated that, as you can see, just moved it around so my moon is sort of just in this back corner here. And on the sky photo, I have added some stars. And just on those stars, they're on screen. So that picture of the stars is on screen. Now it is in front of the sky picture. So what you have to be careful of is you've got no stars in front of the moon here. So on the stars, I'll just grab my erase brush tool, make my brush a little bit smaller. And if there's any stars just on that moon, we're just going to get rid of them, because all the stars would be behind the moon. So just like that, we don't want any stars actually on the moon there. We want them to look like they're behind the moon. So that is looking pretty good at this stage. So what I'm going to do, I've got this picture here of this arch, just the arch here, and that's the only bit of this picture I want. So I've already cut that out, as you can see, and put it in place here. So just that picture of the arch is the only one that I wanted. And I've copied this three times and I've just added it along the road here, as you can see. One, that one's a little bit skew-iff at the back there. So we'll grab our move tool and we'll just move it around and move it up a bit into place. That looks a little bit better. So we've got three of those arches here. And like I said, this is the original picture and I've just cut out this arch. So on each of these arches, I'm going to add an exposure. And just darken that one up a little bit, quite a bit. And on that exposure, I'm going to invert it. Grab my brush, just on a nice soft brush, back on my layers. Make my brush a little bit bigger and just where that light is, I'm just going to paint that sort of out a little bit. About like that is pretty good. The other thing on the arch, I'm going to add a recolor. Again, let's just clip it to that. Let's bring that into the blues. So it's sort of like that light. Again, I'm going to invert it. Still on my brush, still painting on white. Let's make my brush a little bit bigger. Flow maybe up a little bit, about 30%. And I'm just going to paint some of that blue in where I want it. Just sort of around like that. And I'm pretty happy with that. On the top of my arch, I'm going to add a new pixel layer. What I'm going to do is grab my pen tool again. And I'm just going to make a selection around these lights here. sort of down about there to the road and up again. And then once we've got our selection made, I'm going to turn it into just a selection like this. Grab my color tool just to grab that nice blue color that these lights are putting out. And I'm going to fill that with that blue. I'm going to put that on top of the road. On that pixel layer, I'm going to add a mask to it. Get rid of the marching ants and then come over here to my gradient tool. Turn it around so I've got black on the bottom and white up the top. And I'm going to fade that light. About there looks pretty good. On that pixel layer, I'm also going to put a Gaussian blur. I'm going to blur that quite a bit. It looks pretty good. I'm going to make a copy, Command J, and then I'm going to come up here to Arrange and Flip Vertical. Bring that down sort of there and just stretch that out a bit. And drop the opacity a little bit on that one, just so we've got that light sort of coming round in a circle. Okay, while we're here with that light, going to make another copy, Command J, make that quite a bit smaller, and I'm going to put that just up on this arch. Drop the opacity a little bit more. Not going to worry too much about the back of that arch there, but on that middle arch, I'm going to add an exposure. Darken that a little bit. And on the back arch, I'm also going to add an exposure. Darken that a little bit as well. So that is not looking too bad. So what I'm going to do now is add a little bit of fog. So underneath the road, I'm going to add a new pixel layer over to my brush. And I'm going to pick this Dreamography brushes, and I'll link below where you can get those. And I'm going to grab some of this fog brush here. Make sure I've got this sort of color. I'm going to pick it from the moon here, this sort of gray blue color, and activate that. Make my brush a little bit smaller. I'm going to paint in some fog coming underneath the road here, just drifting up on each side of the road and back here a little bit as well. And what we'll do is put another pixel layer above the road, change our brush to this sort of fog one here, make our brush a lot smaller, and then we'll make it look like some of this fog is just coming over onto the road on each side. A little bit bigger, and I'll just put a little bit across the road here as well. So I've got that fog a little bit up in the corners, creating that little bit of atmosphere there. So that looks pretty good at the moment. So we've got our fog in place. What we'll do now is add our character. And if you watched last week's tutorial, we created this character here. So we've got our character. What we'll do is we'll make another copy, Command J. Bottom one we'll call Shadow. On the bottom one we've called Shadow, we'll put a layer effect, and we'll do color overlay and black. We'll drag that down right in front, make our picture a little bit smaller, and we'll just stretch that out a bit. About there, what we'll do is just drop the opacity down, and on that shadow we will do a small Gaussian blur of about 3 pixels, and maybe drop that opacity a little bit more. We can play with that a little bit later. There we go. So we've got that in place. On our character, we'll add an exposure. Darken our character up a little bit. About there. We'll add another exposure. Clip that to our character, and we'll lighten that one up quite a bit. And that one we'll invert. We'll grab our brush, we'll change our brush just to a basic brush. Bit of a soft brush. Get our colours back to default. Let's zoom in on our character here, make our brush a lot smaller. Got our flow about 25. I might turn that up to about 30. And let's just add some of that light to our character here. What we'll do also while we're here on our character, we'll add a recolor. Clip that and we'll bring that into the blue from the light above. And we'll also invert that recolor, still back on our brush. I'm going to add some of that blue as well. Make my brush a little bit bigger. Bring the flow all the way down to about 10%. We'll just sort of add a bit of that blue. About like that. It looks pretty good. Command 0 to get our picture back to normal size. I think our character's looking pretty good there. What we'll do is also now take care of the lightsaber. So what we'll do is add another pixel layer. We'll change the blend mode to glow. And I've decided to make this character the good guy. So I'm going to do a green lightsaber, nice and green right in the middle there. My brush is going to be a really soft brush right down the bottom here. Flow again up to about 30%. Again, I'm going to zoom in. Going to make my brush really small, just about the size of the lightsaber there. Click once right up the top, hold shift down, right to the end and click again. We'll make our brush bigger. We'll drop the flow down to about 15. Click once up the top again and then right down the bottom. Let's click again. So getting that lightsaber look like it is turned on a little bit. A little bit of green down the bottom. I might just put my opacity all the way down to about 15 as well. I might just do a little bit of green. Hold, click once, hold my shift down and just a little bit of green at the bottom there. Command 0 to get back. And that's our character all done with the shadow. We could sort of play with that a little bit more, but that looks okay for now. What we might do now is add our other picture. Now, this picture here, I've just taken the arm of this picture. That's the only bit of this picture that I'm going to use. Again, a lot of these pictures like this character and the background and the arch are all from the photo manipulation bundle stock that you can get if you sign up to their newsletter, which I will link below. But the only part of this character that I've used is the arm. You can see that I've cut it out here and I've just placed it sort of right in the middle here. So what we're going to do with that, we're going to add, as usual, an exposure and darken it down a little bit. I'll add another exposure. Clip that, and that one I'm going to lighten up quite light. And again, that one I'm going to invert. Command I. Back on my brush, let's get our colors back to default, hitting D on the keyboard. Let's bring our opacity all the way back up and our flow back to about 30. And let's just add, we're painting in white, let's just add a little bit of brightness just on those areas there. Tiny little bit at the back, not too much. Maybe the fingers. You can go back to black if you think you've done too much there. Also on the arm, I'm going to do the same with the recolor. So I'm going to add a recolor, drop that onto the arm, bring it into the blues. Again, we will invert that color with a command I. Still got our brush, we're still on 30%, and let's add a little bit of that blue from the light. That looks pretty good. Okay, we have to add the lightsaber in. So let's, on top of the arm here, let's add a new pixel layer. Grabbing our brush, we can bring the flow all the way up to 100%. We're painting in white, but I want to change my brush to a thicker sort of brush here. Let's make that a little bit bigger. And I'm going to put that layer behind the arm. And we're going to make it Let's go a little bit smaller so we can see what we're doing. Right there, click once, hold shift key, and click again. That's a little bit crooked, so what we'll do is just grab our move tool and just move that around so it makes a little bit more sense, maybe about there. Looks pretty good. Command zero to get back again. Let's put another pixel layer on top. We'll change the blend mode to glow. And he's going to be our baddie, so we'll go a red lightsaber. Back on our brush, but we want a softer brush. So let's come down to the soft brushes. Let's change our flow to 30. I might put this one on top of the arm. Clicking once here, holding down my shift right to the bottom, and let's click again. Let's make our brush a little bit bigger. Drop our flow to about 20. Right up the top here, click once, down the bottom, click again. So just a couple of little things that we can do here. Let's come to the city, Gaussian blur, and let's just put one pixel on that, on the city. And on these little arches here, let's go the middle arch and put a Gaussian blur, one pixel on that as well. The far one we don't need to worry too much about, but on the road I might do the Gaussian blur. One pixel on the road, but what I'm going to do with that is on that Gaussian blur, I'm going to grab my brush back to default. I'm going to take away the blur at the front here. So I'll be painting in black on that Gaussian blur and I'm going to take away the front. So let's bring our flow all the way up to 100. And let's just take it away halfway, just so that road is slightly blurring right down at the bottom here. There we go. On the fog on the front, the very front fog, I might just add a little bit of a Gaussian blur on that fog and just blur it a tiny little bit. About like that, I think, is going to be good. So now we can just bring all that together with layer, merge visible. I might use my tone mapping this week on detailed, bringing that down to about 20. Let's bring our vibrance up and let's just bring that detailed refinement up a little bit as well. And let's hit apply. So there we go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site. I've got some assets for the character that we created and the character itself available for you to download, and you can also support my channel there as well. You can also hit that super thanks link just below the video on my channel. But until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.